So I've been really stressed out, and I want to talk about that. This is going to be an improv video, and you know, you may consider it a bit of a rant, but you know, I don't even care. I haven't posted in forever. You guys are probably wondering where I've been, because look, I have quite the meme on this channel of having a terrible upload schedule. That is a surprise to no one. But 2020 is almost up, and I only got one video? Nah, something's going on, and y'all already knew that this was coming. So, stress. How's it been affecting me? How does it affect us, our bodies, you know, all that good stuff? Let's talk about that. Let's have a discussion in a completely non-scripted way. It's gonna be messy, but you know, we're gonna deal with that together as a unit. I believe in us, okay? Believe in me. So, I think I speak for everyone when I say the stress started around the time COVID appeared. You know, we all got locked in our houses, we all became hermits. It wasn't that different for me. I kinda stay inside all the time anyway. My default setting was to basically sit at my computer for long, draining hours and wait for that one moment of the year when I get to see people in person for the first time in forever. Guess what didn't happen this year because of COVID? Yeah. Everything! Okay, I'm getting ahead of myself. Let me back it up a bit. So yeah, lockdown happened. We were all stuck inside. Okay, we all know we're living it right now. When that kinda happened, I gotta say, I should have known that it was going to take a turn for the worse. Because I started this entire year with a fair bit of money, that was my first clue that things were about to come at my buns and eat them like a scrumptious little cake. I can't be financially stable in this economy. No, that's gotta be the first thing to go. The moment that we had to go into lockdown, I kinda took the brunt of responsibility to feed my family and take care of things around the house. I had the most money, so obviously when it came time for somebody to supply and make sure that we had groceries to sustain us for 2-3 months, I was the only one that could raise my hand and be like, "Hey, I'm gonna help us not starve." Now you could say I'm a good little bean for making sure that my family had proper nutrients to withstand this COVID chaos, but I mean, it's just as much for myself as anyone else, right? I don't wanna die of no food. Someone's gotta do it, might as well be me. But that kinda cost me a hefty $400 in groceries because, hi, hello, how are ya? I live with 6 other people, we're all very hungry, and we also have 3 cats and a dog. We pay a lot whenever we gotta feed everybody in this household. On top of that, I had things like therapy, I had vet bills, I had house bills, I had to help pay for a lot of things, so, you know, financial stress. What else is new? That's always something that I've kind of dealt with, and that was sort of step numero uno. Bleh, blah, blah, umo, umo. Yes, umo, I am Spanish speaker, this is how you say one, umo, when we play a card game, umo. I hate, this is improv. This is when you don't have script, you don't speak English. Yes, hello, I'm PJ, this is what you subscribe for, I hope you're happy. But that was step numero uno to making me feel pretty stressed out for the beginning of 2020. Not having money really does suck. I mean, not that I necessarily needed money, because the only reason I was saving up all that money was to go on trips, and hey, guess what's not going on with between me and my pals this year, you know? Yeah, mentioned it already. No VidCon, no California, no other conventions, no fun travels, no vacations. There was so much set aside for this year, I don't think I can really explain to you how much of a great time people were gonna have. I'm pretty sure it was a whole entire meme that because this was the start of an entire decade for our world, that we were gonna be like, yo, let's make this the best start to the new decade ever. This is the day we get our crap together. This is the day that our YouTube channel spark up. This is the day that we care about us. It's gonna be our year. This is it. Let's go! Yeah, see, that didn't happen at all. We completely wasted our time. We picked a terrible year to get our crap together because all of our plans kinda just went down the crapper one by one by one. You wanted to start a tour? Nah. You wanted to go on vacation to Japan? Nah. You wanted to go to VidCon and meet all your friends because you only get to meet them one time a year and you're really sad and you really need their company? Nah! Stay sad. Stay upset. Muerto. If anything, we hated the fact that we only ever got to see each other once a year. So this was sort of supposed to be the year that we were gonna meet up in a whole bunch of different locations across the US and, well, again, needless to say, did not happen. All of those plans were immediately extinguished, and we kind of just had to watch the chips fall where they may and accept that we weren't really going to be seeing anybody this year, which is really hard. I know I call myself a hermit, but if I'm being honest, I really depend on seeing my friends once a year. It's the only way I can emotionally recharge and keep my mood afloat, but who am I kidding? 2020 really gave my feelings the finger and said, choke on it, so frick me, right? Just another check on the crap list, so, you know, why don't we go down this bad boy together? Give it a look-see. Finances whack. General home life, not killing it. No IRL friend time, no vacation. A very toxic atmosphere on Twitter. Just keeps showing us a lot more terrible things happening all across the globe. Doesn't leave a lot of room for emotional escape here. And yes, it all led to an extended period of emotional detachment. Fantastic. It's very rare that the average human be confronted with so many terrible worldwide tragedies every day. Even rarer that they get so little human interaction. So, me facing all that, combined with a lack of comforts, had me receding into myself, and then I guess I eventually just started detaching from my emotions so that I wouldn't feel as bad. I was sad about my home, I was sad about the world, about life, about my work, even. Heck, my last video performed poorly, didn't get the views I was expecting, I lost a sponsorship opportunity, and it really brought down my self-confidence when I didn't exactly have much else to support me at the time. So my subconscious protecting me does sort of make sense, but I still felt the depression peak in. I still felt a lack of motivation. I still felt all my positive emotions being yanked away. The days felt fast and slow at the same time, and I spent most of my time hunched over the computer. I didn't actually start to feel quote-unquote normal again until I decided to finally move away from my home. Fun life update, actually. I'm trying to move out to Ohio with my friend Rebecca-chan. I would tell her to say hi, but I'm not gonna ask her for audio, so, sorry, Baka. But, you know, I'm finally leaving this home behind, and it's great, but I think putting a time restraint on it forced me to confront all those other emotions and problems that I had swept to the back of my mind. Like, it was very present and I couldn't avoid it, so all those detached feelings came flooding back in and basically incited multiple anxiety attacks for the past month. It's been great. Love it. Just like I love the random energy burst it gave me that my body was totally prepared to handle after being stagnant for so long, and it totally didn't lead to me moving more than I was capable of and hurting my ankles, legs, arms, and spine in the process. I think I mostly hurt the nerves in there and like my muscles, but it's contributed to my lack of art and kind of kept me away from my computer for a fair period of time. Mostly because I gotta do a lot of stretches and keep myself in motion, you know, so the pain doesn't set in. So if you've been wondering to yourself at all, where's BJ? Where's she been? Why hasn't she uploaded? This one's for you, buddy. But I've been getting better. Truth be told, I actually was working on a video before all this, and it's really fun, and I actually really love it. But I want to get this video out so that you guys have something to see, so that you guys know what's been going on with me, and so that it'll kind of hold you over until I'm finished with this other one. I am literally so close to finishing the storyboard, you have no idea. And then, like, once that's done, I just need to line and color, like, guys, it is gonna be here probably next month, such is the hope. And maybe from that moment on, I can keep giving you guys some shorter videos to make up for the intense lack of content. Overall, I just want to tell you guys that I'm sorry. I'm sorry for the lack of content. I'm sorry I haven't been my best self. I'm sorry to my patrons who are paying money that haven't gotten to see anything yet. I'll probably adjust that so that you don't have to pay me unless I post. I'm sorry to my Discord because I haven't been as active on there lately as I've wanted to be. I'm sorry to my mods. I'm sorry to my dog. You could probably hear him barking in the background. Snoopy! Forgive me! I'm sorry to my pals for not being there more. I'm sorry to you guys for not being better. And I'm really sorry to every single one of you bedheads. But You know, without being too cheesy, I'm probably most sorry to myself, because I am not being the person that I want to be, I'm not feeling like the person I want to feel like, and I have just let myself down way more than I should have. And I know I deserve to be better, I know I owe it to other people and myself to be better in every way that I can. I'm gonna try my best to get better so that I can post and feel great and be happy and get moolah and do all that good stuff that adults are supposed to do, like move out of my house. And hopefully, if any of you guys have been going through a stressful time too, you know that you can also improve and get better just like I am. I think we can still do our best, and I think we can still find a way to make good of this very poor situation that we're all in. But for now, I think I finally gotta let this audio go. God only knows how long it's actually gonna be. I'm gonna have to doodle so much crap for this. They're gonna be such bad doodles. I'm just gonna say that ahead of time, but I'ma head out. I'm very tired, so good night, bedheads. Sleep tight, and don't forget to follow your dreams. Crappy Audio PJ here, reminding you that no matter how stressful it's been for a lot of us self-quarantining and worrying about the health of ourselves and our family, you should still self-quarantine whenever possible. Wash your hands, wear your masks, and social distance. This whole video is just kind of a vent, so don't take my whining as me encouraging negligence. I've been following all the recommendations. I just had a big hit on my mental health, and it debilitated me for months. A lot of what I talk about is stuff my therapist was telling me about how I cope, so you know, just thought I'd talk about it. Vent, you know, it's healthy. I'm gonna let out these emotions, guys, come on. On a lighter note, like I said, I am gonna be moving out, but I still plan to work on videos, so while you wait, maybe just rewatch this video to tide you over in the meantime, get in the pantsless pajamas mood, maybe buy my merch, I don't know. I made new merch, and I know my merch guys would want me mentioning it. It was supposed to be for summer, but you know, we in fall now. Oopsie. Anyway, enjoy all this fan art, hug a puppy, and love yourself. Mwah. Bye.